how do you ensure that when you are trying to grow and scale your business, that you're doing it in the right way and you're hiring the right amount of people at the right time? How is it going, ladies and gentlemen? This is Sean Barnes. I want to welcome you back to The Way of the Wolf. On the show today, I'm going to be talking about overhiring or hiring too many employees too fast. And to highlight what can go wrong when you do this, I'm going to reflect back on my career about 5 years ago. We had made an acquisition where the company had some very aggressive sales targets that they had set for the organization. And in an effort to ensure that they were able to meet those targets, they started to hire more employees. And so they had this aggressive ramp in terms of sales targets, and then they hired a whole bunch of employees to align to ensure that they could get all of the product out the door. Now, unfortunately, those sales targets didn't materialize. And what that meant is we ended up having to terminate a good bit of their employees, which is very frustrating and challenging for all parties involved, as you might imagine. Now, that does speak to the importance of making sure that your salespeople and those that are forecasting your business actually know what they're doing and that you trust them. That's a conversation for another day. But what I really want to dive into is how do you ensure that when you are trying to grow and scale your business, that you're doing it in the right way and you're hiring the right amount of people at the right time? One of the challenges that you inevitably are going to encounter is you're going to have ebbs and flows and ups and downs in terms of revenue for your organization. And when you get a big contract or you land a new client, you need to make sure that you have enough employees to actually service the work or get the product out the door. Again, you have to make sure that you've got some sort of contractual commitment in place to ensure that you're not staffing up for a company that's just going to pull back immediately. Now, these things happen. This is just part of building a business, but we need to do everything we can to kind of mitigate that risk and prevent it from blowing up your business. Now, I also understand how attractive explosive growth can be. A lot of business owners, they want to get in and make tons and tons of money and just make it rain, right? That's where their heads are at whenever they start a business. But you have to do it in the right way. So whenever you see this bucket of gold over here and you think, okay, well, I've got to get all of these employees on board so that I can actually service the work, great. Also consider that it's going to take time to train those employees and get them to where they can deliver that service or product at the level of quality that you want to deliver for your customers. That's a very big piece. All right. So the things that I'm going to be talking through, you are going to need a little bit of runway and data to be able to calculate this. But one metric that I have found that is extremely beneficial for you to keep an eye on is revenue per employee. And I'm going to speak in round numbers here, but if you have a $10 million business and you have 10 employees to be able to get the product out the door, one employee per $1 million, or for every $1 million, you need another employee. Again, these are not going to match each other perfectly forever because at some point you're going to have to hire administrative staff and people that don't directly generate revenue. They indirectly generate revenue by creating support structures in the business. But this is a great metric for you to go by. You're going to need a couple of months, quite a few months, probably, if not a few years of data to be able to look and start correlating. Okay, if we do $1 million a year for one person, that's great. If we do $10 million for 10 people, this is the number that we want to look at. Once you have that number, then you've got a target to shoot for. as revenue starts to increase, then you start bringing in the employees to service that work so that you have this upward trajectory of both revenue and headcount. Again, it's not going to match perfectly, but it is important that you keep an eye on this metric. Another thing that I really want you guys to consider is, what is the ramp rate of new employees coming into your business? And by that, what I'm really talking about is, how long does it take before they reach maximum productivity with minimal guidance and direction? I think a good rule of thumb here is 3 to 6 months before they really hit their stride and are able to do the things that they need to do. Now, you can move that faster, you can make that faster or slower, really kind of depending on what you're hiring for. When you're interviewing these candidates and when you're looking for specific individuals to come into your organization, if you pay a premium, higher salary for someone that has years or even decades of experience, they're likely going to ramp up significantly faster. However, on the flip side of that, if you hire somebody who only has a couple of months or maybe a year of experience, it's important that you understand you're going to pay less for them in terms of their salary, but you're probably going to have to spend a lot more time training and mentoring and guiding them. Now, there's pros and cons to both approaches, but that is another thing that it's important for you to consider. So really, when you break all of this down, it comes down to revenue per headcount, and then what is the ramp rate when you get these people in your business? These are some important things for you to be aware of and understanding. As we grow this business, what do all of these things look like? And then track them. Whenever you do your monthly financial review calls, because I know you are, you need to also be tracking these types of metrics and understanding, am I hiring too fast or are we not hiring fast enough? Yes, there is risk in not hiring fast enough because the work has to get done. And so you as the founder, you as the leader, you are going to have to pick up the slack, which risks burnout for you, or the rest of the team is going to have to pick up the slack, which risks burnout for them. So this is an important thing for you to keep an eye on as your business is growing and scaling. Ultimately, what's most important is that you find a balance that works for you and your team. It has to be sustainable. I've seen far too many instances of companies that just experience this explosive growth and they don't know how to deal with it. As you're growing, you're going to have to put in systems and processes and hire the right people. And this is a journey for you. It's a journey for everybody on your team. And we can't lose sight of that. We have to make sure that you have a vision and mission and purpose that you can convey to all of the people on your team. They understand where you're going because it's going to be a rocky ride. But having a little bit of insight into some of these key metrics can help you whenever it comes to understanding what does the rate of growth look like. And when you're keeping an eye on the data, it makes it much easier for you to make more informed decisions. Yes, that gut feeling is important when it comes to your business. However, ensuring that that gut feeling also aligns with the data that you are collecting is an important piece of this process. The last thing that I'm going to leave you with, I recently created a post, and we've all seen this, where there's an image where it shows work, 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 and then explosive growth on the back end. And then people say, oh, well, this is all luck. Well, you put in all this work. Now, I've been thinking about this a lot recently because all of that work that you're putting in, it can feel like you're running on a treadmill or like a hamster in a hamster wheel, and you feel like, God, I'm not getting anywhere. It is important that while you are doing all of that work, that you are taking notes, that you are picking up on cues and clues and seeking guidance from friends and coaches and mentors so that you can learn. Because all of that work that you're putting in, you're building yourself. And when you build yourself into a stronger version, a more educated version of yourself, that is when inevitably you're going to see the pop at the end where all things start to fall into place. But you have to be intentional about all of the work that you're doing along the way. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I think that's all I have for the show today. Hopefully this was beneficial and helpful for all of you. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me, Sean at the Way of the Wolf, and happy to just jump on a quick call and chop it up with you guys. Y'all have a good one.